The story begins in the winter of 2017. The margin for victory in hunting is often narrow. Errors will be made by all hunters. What you're about to see is what we thought was the wounding and losing of a mature South Texas buck.
That's him. Right there, dude. Come to my heart. He's 120 yards. He's right there. Get over here. If you feel confident, take him. Yeah. Hold on. Are you on fire? Yeah. That's him. Rack another one. You got him in your neck. Rack another one. Shoot another one, dude. Give him another one. You got him in your neck.
We followed the blood trail for a mile and a half, until we reached an area so thick and so dense, we had to crawl on our hands and knees. We had thorns all in our body, and we searched hard. The days and weeks following, we hunted hard for this buck, and we searched, looking for birds in the sky, possibly identifying where his carcass was. Nothing. Back at deer camp, there was a quietness, a stillness, a sadness. In the weeks and months following, we accepted that this buck died and we would never find him. With the memories of 2017 behind us, we were looking forward to 2018 deer season. First couple of weekends we hunted, saw a lot of young and middle-aged deer, and as you'd expect, the big boys, they don't start to move until the rut approaches, and that's really what we're waiting for. That's when our mature, ghost-like deer start to move. These mature deer, you don't see them all year. You don't see them in velvet. You don't see them in the summer. But when the rut approaches, that's when the magic happens. And to our amazement, what happens next is a testament to the survival instinct and willpower of a whitetail buck. Absolutely incredible. Notice here, there's a middle-aged buck about 50 yards from my dad's deer blind. The buck that was wounded in 2017 and we presumed dead shows up, drooling and ready to fight.
You got it, man.